it's Jessie V. So yes, my shirt does indeed say don't cry. I don't really know why I decided to buy this shirt, but I don't know why I do half the things I do, so. I never thought I'd wear a crying person on my body, but you know, it's fine. All right, so I posted a video about a week ago showing you guys a cursed item that I got from somebody. Now I say cursed in quotes because that's what they claim. I can't prove if it is or not unless I literally go and wear it and find out. But as I was saying in that video, I was really curious about the history of that necklace because she told me a little bit. She said her great grandma found it in a theater dressing room and decided to take it. And ever since then, whoever wore it received bad luck. But I never knew the detail of the bad luck, like what exactly happened. I never really knew the detail of whose necklace it was to begin with. I was just really curious and wanted to know more. As usual. So because this person posted a picture of her and I on Instagram, I was able to like remember who gave me the necklace and find that person and DM them on Instagram. So I just asked them if they would be comfortable telling me the history so I can make a video about it, and they definitely seem to be. So today, oh my goodness guys, they wrote me a giant story about this necklace and all the details about it, and because you guys wanted me to make this video, I'm gonna read the story about it. Now it is pretty long, but it's also very intriguing, so just sit back, relax, grab some popcorn. If you don't like popcorn, I don't know. Fruit Loops. Do you guys have Fruit Loops in the States? I don't even know. Apparently you guys don't have ketchup chips in the States? What in the world? When I went to Pennsylvania a week ago to see my family there, everyone was so like, why are there only ketchup chips in Canada? We want some. And I mean, I don't know. Oh, by the way, I do have the necklace here with me that I'm just gonna like hold in my hand while I read this story. And no, I have not yet worn it just because this story really freaks me out. And as curious as I am, I don't know if I wanna go through with wearing it. So I'll let you guys listen to this story, and if you really want me to make a video with me testing it out, actually wearing it, guys, let me know down below. Give this video a thumbs up if you want me to. I could just like wear it for a day and vlog my whole experience. I'm insane. Anyways, let me read it to you. You decide. You let me know what you want me to do. Okay, here we go. Hi Jessie, I'm so glad you were able to find my Instagram account to talk to me about this. I really wanted to write more about the necklace, but I wasn't entirely sure if you'd be interested, and I also didn't want to freak you out or anything. This story freaks me out. The necklace you have has a ton of history to it, and because of that, I really hope you don't throw it out. After hearing this, if you want to get rid of it, I totally understand, but please mail it back to me or give it to someone who would want to keep it. I'm asking this of you because the necklace is from my great-grandma, and it would make me sad to see it thrown in the trash. And that I totally understand. I totally respect that. I know in the last video I made, I was saying how I put it in my garage because I didn't want it in my house. And after saying that and hearing this, that was kind of disrespectful of me. I didn't want to make it sound like I didn't care about it at all. This stuff just sort of freaks me out and intrigues me at the same time. But don't worry, it hasn't been kept in my garage. It's been put in a box in my guest room, and then I'll sort of decide what to do with it from there. But yes, I will mail it back to you if I decide not to keep it. Or if you just want it back for some reason, like ever, I will return it to you. Obviously, this means a lot to your family, and I would never want to keep something that you want in your family, you know? So whenever you want it back, girl, just let me know. So let's continue her story. Okay, so I can tell you only what I know at this point. I've heard these stories while I was growing up, so I may have lost some of the details, but I'll do the best I can. That's all I'm asking of you, girl. My great-grandma was born in 1921, back when people were wearing corsets, before television was around, and things were so different. I can't even imagine what it would have been like to live back in that time. The world has changed so much, it's insane to even think about how things were back then. A lot of people's entertainment came from going to shows. She had always wanted to be an actress or a dancer, but she was just too young to do that. So when she was 11 or 12, she would hang out in the dressing rooms and would help the ladies put on their makeup and their costumes. One day after a show, she spotted a gorgeous pearl necklace that was hanging from one of the mirrors. She asked around to find out whose it was, and no one claimed it. She did this for about a week, and absolutely no one knew where it came from. So because it seemingly had no owner, she decided to take it for herself. I mean, that's kind of fair, right? I mean, she asked around for a whole entire week and absolutely nobody was saying it was theirs. But is that still, I guess that's still technically stealing. Is that stealing? I don't know. But as I said before, it's definitely not real pearls. It's definitely costume jewelry pearls, so I couldn't imagine this would cost a lot anyway. And to someone who's 11 or 12 years old, it's like cool to like own something like this. I know I had a ton of long pearl like fake necklaces as a kid that I wore with all my dresses and all kinds of stuff. So if no one claimed it, I guess she wanted to take it. At first, she didn't wear it. She just kept it on her bedside table. But she began having dreams about it, and she somehow felt compelled to put it on. This is what I hear about like all kinds of cursed items, and that's why it freaks me out. Although I personally have not felt compelled. Like, in fact, I'm like freaked out by it. Anyway, she somehow felt compelled to put it on, so one day she did. She wore it to school, and that's where things began to get weird. Four of her pencils broke during class. Every time she asked for a new one, it would snap almost immediately. Then the boy sitting behind her pulled on her braids the whole day, and before this, they had never had any interaction. Then she fell down during recess and scraped her knee pretty bad. And then she got a piece of bubblegum stuck to her uniform that took forever to get out. Now, at first, she didn't blame any of this on the necklace, because how would she have known? True, it's not like you go to school and have a bad day and be like, it must have been the shoes I put on today. Like, she wouldn't really like think about the necklace, I guess. But the next day, she forgot to put on the necklace, and her entire day was completely fine. And then the next day she wore it again and mayhem broke out once more. She forgot her lunch at home, so she had no food to eat at school. She failed a test that she had studied extremely hard for. She got in trouble by the teacher and had to sit in the corner of the classroom while everyone laughed. And she had a spider crawl up her leg afterwards. My goodness, girl. Your great grandma went through some stuff. This became a pattern whenever she wore the necklace. So eventually she put two and two together. She thought that because she took it from the theater, bad luck was after her. Oh yeah, like a karma thing? Yeah, I get that. She stopped wearing it for 20 years and placed it in a little box that she refused to go near. Sounds like what I did. I put it in a box and I put it in my guest room and I was like, okay, that can stay over there. She then had a daughter who I would know as my grandma. Oh, okay. Because this was first your great-grandma, so she had a daughter, so this is your grandma you're talking about. And because kids are curious, she one day came upon this box with the necklace. The moment she saw it, she thought it was so beautiful, so right away she put it on. My great-grandma didn't notice her daughter had done this right away because she hid it underneath her shirt and went about her day. Surprisingly, my grandma had a day filled with good luck. What? In fact, she came home with a huge smile on her face because everything had gone perfectly. When she told my great-grandma about this, she spotted the necklace on her neck. She couldn't believe how her daughter's day was completely fine all day with it on. Yeah, that's so weird. Because her great-grandma had constant bad luck whenever she wore it, but her daughter had the opposite. They soon discovered that it was almost like the necklace chose who to give bad luck to and who to give good luck to. When my great-grandma tried to wear it again for the first time in 20 years, her cat ran away and was never to be seen again. But whenever her daughter wore it, something amazing would happen. That is so weird. I kind of want to know what these amazing things were. And then when my mom came along and eventually found out about this necklace in her teens, she wanted to wear it just to see what would happen to her. You guys are very brave. And unfortunately, she got the bad luck. The first time she wore it, she had someone in the parking lot scratch her car when they opened the door to get out. She also forgot her purse at a store in the mall and had to go all the way back to look for it. I will admit that I've worn it once, and nothing bad has happened to me. In fact, I got 97% on my math exam, which was crazy because math has always been a subject I have struggled with. That is so weird. It's like every other person in your family gets good or bad luck. It's like a pattern. That is so weird. But maybe this only affects your family, because maybe since your great-grandma took the necklace, then that whole line of people in your family get the bad or good luck. Like, maybe this wouldn't affect me at all because it's only associated with your family. You know what I mean? Like, maybe me having it just makes it a normal necklace. And then she said, like, sort of what I said at the beginning to you guys. She said, I know you may not want to do this, but I think you should make a video where you wear the necklace for a day and see what luck you have. Even if it's bad luck, nothing from my family's history has ever been extremely unsafe or terrible. It's always just been little things, so I'm not too worried about it. And if it's good luck, then that's great, right? I'm just very curious. But if you don't want to, I understand. Just let me know if you'd like to mail it back to me. So that's interesting, and I don't really know how to feel about this whole thing. I mean, honestly, I haven't been compelled by it or anything. It's just been in the box in my guest room, so I haven't felt like I haven't had any feelings towards it, you know what I mean? And it seems like everyone in your family has. So this might just affect you guys, as bad as that sounds. But I don't know, like, what do you guys think about this whole necklace thing? Do you think it's real? Do you think maybe it's just in her family? Do you think that I should wear it for a day and just, like, see what happens? Definitely comment down below if you want me to and, like, vlog my experience, give this video a thumbs up, and let me know if you think I shouldn't, then just comment down below and say, Jessie, do not do this. But I am a very curious person. Anyways, though, guys, I thought you'd just enjoy this sort of history of the necklace, because after making the video I did a week ago, a lot of you guys were left with questions, as was I, so here are sort of your answers. And yeah, I hope you guys have an awesome rest of your day, and I will see you in my next video.